I just want to show you how to make a curvy sort of tubular thing which could be used for rope or vines or wires or whatever, spindly looking tube things you can think of inside of Maya. I'm just going to show you a really really quick way of doing it. Just going to delete these. This was me testing it out. So the first thing we're going to do is come to a side view, and what we're going to do is go up to the create tool in the corner and go to EP curve tool. You can use any of the curve tools. I prefer EP curve tool because it has some cool features which I will show you now. So just going to draw a little curve like this and hit enter. And we're going to go to the vertex select tool, and here you can make any alterations to the model that you want. Say model to the curve that you want. So we want it to be a bit more droopy down there. We want this to sort of go like here, this to go here. I'm not going to worry about it too much for this demonstration, but you get the idea. So with that made, we're then going to spawn in a cylinder. We're going to slap him up there, and then we're going to delete the bottom faces. So do that. Come to this viewport, it's going to be easier. Oops. Oh gosh, what did I just do? Yeah, right, delete the bottom faces. Get the lines, and we're going to delete the lines from in there so that you're just left with this plain face. And then we're going to modify center pivot so that our pivot point is directly in the middle. What we want to do now is have this plane directly snap to the curve tool. So we're going to hold down C and the middle mouse button and just drag it. It may take you a couple of tries to get it where we want it to be, but before long it should. It should, she says. It's snapped there. It's difficult for you to see, but I'm dragging my mouse all over the screen, and it is basically this thing is now locked onto the curve. So we're going to drag it to the start of the curve over here. Zoom into it. Gonna scale it down ever so slightly and position it like that. We want it to kind of follow the angle of the curve. Scale it down a little bit more. So what we want to do now is you will need to select the face that we've just created and then shift select the curve tool. You cannot do that through the modeling toolkit on the right-hand side. So over here where they're currently flashing, it just won't work if you use these. So you'll have to hold down right-click and select the face tool this way. And then that way, if you try and do it, if I show you, if you try and do it over here by selecting face, and then you just can't shift select the curve tool. So what you'll need to do is come over to this little menu, drag down to face, select face, and then shift select the curve. Press Control E, and now this will extrude it from point A to point B, which is the end point of the actual model. All we need to do now is come to divisions. By default, you can only drag it to 25. But if you click on this little box here and then type in, you can add as many as you want. So I've put 100 divisions, that's way too many. But yeah, you've got that. If we click off it now, basically what I did, I had the face facing the wrong way. If this happens, just press Control D to duplicate it and drag it out. And then what you can do is take your faces and then mesh display and reverse. Or initially you can have the face go in the right way. The reason I duplicated it is because this one tends to hold, it's gonna sound weird, but the memory of what you've just done to it. So if you duplicate it, that just makes it a static mesh rather than a curve tool. And I think if we delete the curve, yeah, if we delete the curve, it deletes the other one, whereas if you duplicate it, it's fine. Yeah, and that's it's just a really, really quick way of making tubular looking things inside Maya. Obviously, you'll make things that look a lot better than this, but yeah, somebody requested this earlier and I just wanted to show you how to do it really quickly. So, yeah.